Bonjour et salut à tous et merci de m'avoir rejoint encore une fois pour une nouvelle campagne qu'on va lancer aujourd'hui avec la Bretonnie qui vient juste de sortir aujourd'hui. Pardon me, frog in my throat. Hello everybody and welcome back once again. My name is Jordan, also known as J-Monster. Thank you for joining me once again for a new campaign which we're going to be beginning today with Bretonnia. Luan Lercoeur is going to be our legendary lord. I think you guys are going to enjoy this. I've never actually played with Bretonnia before and I'm not very familiar with their new mechanics, so this is going to be a bit of an adventure and a learning experience for all of us. Hope you guys enjoy it.
Does war visit fair Bretonnia this day? It is no longer enough for the dukes to sit idle. It is time for the flower of Bretonnia to unfurl and reveal its thorns. Come to his court with a wealth of knowledge that will aid this errantry war. Like the Grail companions of old, the dukedoms of Bretonnia will unite under the banner of their king. Greetings to you, benevolent Royak. Blessed is your rule over Bretonnia. Yet darkness spreads from abroad and threatens your kingdom. The threat is real. It must be faced. To the east, the greedy merchant princes of Marienburg conspire to consolidate their riches. Observe that much wealth flows into Marienburg, but very little emerges. Further south, in the Grey Mountains, greenskins and dwarfs vie for control of the peaks. Whoever wins may yet cause trouble for you, my lord. Beyond, the wood elves in their mysterious forest protect their homes. Whilst at the coast, the Duke of Bordello is as unpredictable as the roiling sea and as secretive as the watery depths. Elsewhere, the unliving lords of Mousillon wage war against mortal men. The bickering dukedoms ignore the looming threat, and so it falls to you to act, my liege. Only a united Bretonnia can face these growing perils. Raise your banner, King Lioncoeur, and drive this evil from the world in the lady's blessed name.
So it appears that we have our work cut out for us. Hey, you, shut up. Nobody wants to hear what you have to say. Alright, what is this? My lord, the Dukes of Bretonnia have resided under a chivalrous code for many years. Under this tradition, build upon the great foundations of Gilles le Breton and lead the knightly orders forward to glory. 400 chivalry. Alright. Chivalry is increased through noble actions, heroic victories, and lost through dishonorable deeds. Okay. Your current chivalry level can be seen on the campaign interface at the top of the screen. There is no greater benefit of chivalry than the assistance of the Green Knight. Oh, look at that. Down there we got a little button. Allows us to summon the Green Knight. This legendary hero can be called upon in times of need to destroy those that oppose you, peasants. Peasants form the backbone of your army and economy, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so don't recruit too many peasant militia units without having a lot of growth is what I'm getting from this.
You honor me.
Who are you? Who are you? That's why, damsel, alright. Get in my army.
Lady, honor me.
We've got kind of a pathetic starting force. And not really a whole lot of economy to back us up. Peasant economy, minus 10 upkeep for all non-knight units. That's kind of nice. Farms working at full capacity. Well, over here we seem to have the greenskins and the greedy merchants of Marienburg, who we've been warned to be wary of. I would like to fight them, but I don't think that we really have the forces to storm a wall. Our greatest strength is going to be out in the field. That's what we're going to do. Let's move over this way. Recruit ourselves a couple of peasants. Let's do that. Yeah, unfortunately that is going to... Yeah. Warning, there are more peasants in your armies than you can sustain. Recruiting units. These units will have a negative impact on my farming income, which is going to hurt our economy, but honestly I need the units. So let's go ahead and do that. Chivalry code. Plus 5 chivalry. That's kind of nice. Also, plus 4 growth is nicer, and plus 3 income from everything is going to be even better, because we're going to need it. Let's see here. A smithy! Enables men-at-arms with shields. Can we do that already? No, we cannot. That is the second upgrade. The thing we cannot recruit right now is knightly orders, which is a little bit unfortunate when you're playing Bretonnia and all you really have is your cavalry to rely on. So let's see. Abbey of the Grail Companion. It's probably not relevant to us at the moment. Military support. Stables. Okay. Let's build the stables. Definitely important. We want to keep our military in tip-top shape. I could get rid of this, but you know, I don't think I'm going to, because we're not going to have any infantry whatsoever. And we're going to have to deal with just a few peasant units that we have already. And I got a feeling that they're going to die like dogs in our first battle. So let's not do that. We'll save a little bit of money right there. Let's try and open up... Yeah, let's try to open up some lanes of commerce with our knightly neighbors. Let's see. Lyonnais. You want to be friends? They seem to like us. Let's try a trade agreement. That worked. Beautiful. Castle Artois. Like Stella Artois. I like it. Perhaps they produce beer here. We should be friends with these people. Artois. The laws of chivalry demand. They like us slightly less. Let's try an aggression pact. Good, good. Okay, now our relation is going to improve. So we have our foot in the door with Artois. Maybe we'll be able to make a couple of allies, because we definitely need them. We're in kind of a weak position up here in the north. We're kind of bottled up a little bit. They're looking quite feeble over here, but they're going to get a castle garrison, which is going to be nearly impossible for us to take without a very long and protracted siege. And, I don't really think I can sit there for like 10 turns and do nothing with my one army. That's taking up all of my economy. So what we're going to do is, what's this? Oh, beautiful! Temporary recruitment cost. No, let's go with growth for now. So let's go ahead and pass the turn. And what I'm going to do next time is plop my army down in ambush stance and see if we can't make friends with everybody else and just kind of secure our western flank, which will funnel our enemies, who are quite bottled up themselves, into this one area, which will allow us to ambush them. And ambushes with heavy cavalry armies, I can imagine, could be very devastating. Greenskin incursions. Minus 20 control. The insidious greenskins are coming! Okay, so apparently they're raiding our lands, and now we're having a huge public order issue right out the gate, which is not great. That could definitely... Things could definitely be going better. But unfortunately, I'm kind of stuck here. I'm not too sure what to do, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pass a few turns, and I'll see you guys in just a moment. Okay, so bad things have happened. We've let our public order get a little bit out of control. Wasn't really anything I could do about it to begin with. And looks like the Greenskins have raised a tiny little army here, which we're going to go and crush. Because we can. And it's a pretty pathetic force, but you know what? We're going to go ahead and fight it. Ooh, Goblin Spider Riders. Alright, I'll see you guys on the battlefield. Alright, so the lady has been kind to us and has allowed us a very superior position up here on a hill, where we've managed to get our catapults and both of our units of bowmen into a brutal, brutal hilltop fortress, essentially, where we can rain death and destruction down upon the Greenskins. But before we get started, let's just take a moment and bask in the glorious HD, because this is the first time I think we've done a Warhammer battle since I got my new processor, and it's beautiful! Look at this. It's so pretty. Let's go take a look at our Grail Knights. Alright, so our deployment, our plan is going to be to hide our cavalry over here in the woods, and we're going to draw them in to this area here, where Luan Leoncoeur and the Damsel are waiting to greet him with sword and bow and lance. And let's go ahead and let's get started. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, some Orc Era boys. There's quite a lot more of them. Looks like we got some... Oh no, some spider riders. Ugh, how disgusting. I hate the way that they skitter. And coming down here across this river. But we're going to be waiting for them. Oh yeah, we've got some Pegasus Knights here just kind of hanging out doing whatever. I think what my plan is going to be is to draw those spider riders into this area right here where I'm going to hit them and hold them in place with our Pegasus Knights. And then I'm going to come in on the side and flank. Or on the flank and rear, I should say, with my two units of Knights Errant. At least that's the idea. Look at these guys. Damn, they look cool. I've never actually really played much with Petronia before, so this is all quite new to me. Oh, those poor Orc Era boys. I feel bad for them, not at all. What do we got here? Some Spider Riders, and more Spider Riders. Alright. Let's let them seal their own fate. And come a little bit closer. Slowly begin to move forward with our Grail Knights. And we're gonna jump on these guys. Alright. Now it's the time. Charge! For Bretonnia! I'm gonna bring my Grail Knights and my Knights of the Realm around on the left, and we're going to catch these guys in a brutal pincer movement. Let's take you guys to a different group, and we'll move forward down the hill with our infantry. Now was the time! Luanel, go! Charge! Charge! Let's take on these Night Goblins. How are we doing over here? Complete and utter devastation. Looks like we got some goblins in there as well. Oh, that's a little bit unfortunate. Let's pull our Pegasus Knights out of there and use them for what they do best, that being harassing these kinds of vulnerable units. How are our Knights Errant doing so far? Not bad. Let's pull them back up the hill and get a nice downhill charge against those goblins. The rest of our forces, now bring them in to the rear of these goblins. Attack, brothers! Oh, this is going to be very unfortunate. Looks like another unit of Spider Riders over there. Let's bring them into the backs of these goblins. Finish them off. Hey, what are you doing? Lorneon Curl, looks like he needs a little bit of help from us. These guys up and around. I'm going to hammer and anvil these Night Goblins, which should send them running for the hills. Lorneon Curl holding down the fort pretty much on his own and apparently winning slightly against that horde of goblins, so great on you, buddy. This is going to be the end of these Night Goblins, I think. And I'll teach them to trespass on fair Bretonnia. Look at this. I feel so bad for you. Yeah, those Night Goblins are going to get their day ruined a little bit. What are we doing here? Looks like our Knights Errant taking a little bit more casualties than what I would have liked to have had. But oh well, it happens. I think we might have also been shooting at them with our trebuchets, which is a bit of an oops on my part. Clearly my micro still has a lot of work to do to play with this new cavalry heavy faction. It's very fast paced though, I quite enjoy it. Okay, so that's pretty much the end of them. I will see you actually, no, hold on. I know you guys like to see the casualty screens, so we'll check that out first, then I'll see you back on the campaign map. There you are, look at that. 110 on our most damaged unit of Knights Errant. Not bad, guys. And there you have it. A decisive victory! And it's a shame we don't have three more troops. No, I don't want to decrease my really? Ransoming captives decreases my chivalry? You'd think that, you know, that would be something that would increase your chivalry. It's actually the exact opposite of what happens in Medieval 2. So I guess we'll go ahead and we'll murder them, because, you know, executing helpless prisoners is chivalric. Ooh, whoa. Some levels up here. Questing vow, Grail vow. Oh, that reduces all of the upkeep for many of our better units, which is great. We're going to take that first. What do you get? Harmonic Convergence. Reduces the cooldown. This is going to be really important for keeping our infantry alive. Actually, I should have been using her more during the battle. Still things to learn. And let's take these guys. Can we put them all inside of Kuran? Getting there. Come on.
King Luan Leoncoeur.
Apparently we're not close enough. What I should be doing is chasing these guys down. Oh well, we'll do that in the next turn. Marion Burke has a very large army. I don't trust them not to attack us very shortly. They don't seem to have any interest in these orcs. It would appear that there's some kind of insidious alliance between these two. That could definitely cause us some problems in the future. But,
Champion of the lady.
I don't know, let's pass turn and see what happens. I'm afraid something bad's gonna happen. Kuron! What the hell is happening in Kuron? Oh, it's those bastards again. They've got a larger army than last time. Where the hell did they get a rock lobber? Alright. Apparently we have to completely annihilate these guys, so I'll see you guys back on the battlefield. You know, it occurred to me that we really should be auto-resolving these kinds of things, but there was no glory to be had in such victories for the lady and so forth. So, we're probably going to fight most of our battles, unless it's so insignificant that it's not really worth our time. So let's go ahead and let's get started. Same plan pretty much from the last time. I'm going to take my cavalry and move them all around here, so we can crush these guys down in the valley. And at the same time, we're going to be laying down some devastating fire with our trebuchets up on the top of the hill. Because once again, the lady has favored us, and we have spawned on top of a hill, while our opponent has spawned down in a valley. Hardly seems fair, but oh my goodness, they're shooting us with that friggin' rock lobber. You bastards! Nope, 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 nope. Hey, you. Get over there. Destroy that rock lobber. It would appear that these guys want a little bit of a fight. I'm more than inclined to give it to them. What are these, Grail Knights? Charge! Cherchez pour la Bretonnie! Alright, now let's set ourselves up for some complete destruction. Oh, looks like we got some forest goblin riders here. Definitely came to the wrong neighborhood. These guys hit them hard. Unfortunately, these guys are gonna get shot by those damned arrow boys, but hey, such is life. Let's take down that rock lava, it's definitely a big problem. How are things going up here? I think we need to move our infantry forward. Definitely time to launch our attack with Luan Leoncoeur on his knight's errant. Charge! We've crushed those spider riders, now we're free to get into their archers. This fight is pretty much over. Let's go take a look. Look at that. Destruction of these orc arrow boys. And look at all these poor bastards now, trapped down here in this valley. Free to be run down by our cavalry at our leisure. Charge, my brothers! For fair Bretonnia! Oop. What we got going on here? Very, very tiny infantry engagements. Looks like that might be their general, which is fine. I'm going to bring some spearmen down here to support our cavalry, bring them into the rear of those night goblins. I can't seem to click on this bastard. There you go, peasants. Attack him with your farming implements. We've broken through on that side. Alright, we'll bring the rest of them around and surround night goblins, who are doing better than I would have expected against my cavalry, but apparently they're now running for the hills. Good job, everyone! My peasants were probably shooting people. Again, I need to get better at microwing. These Pegasus Knights did a number on that artillery piece. That's pretty much the end of these goblins. Alright, let's check out the casualties. And there you have it. Oh, look at that. Another 109 on one of those Knights Errant. Damn, guys. Damn. Again, we'll execute them, because that's honorable and stuff. And that's going to be the end of that army. We are looking a little bit worse for where Icky. Yeah, goodbye, Icky. Fire resistance, plus one control. Well, that's nice. Some decent looking followers. Another level as well from Monsieur Leoncoeur. Let's see. Income from all buildings. Yeah, definitely need that.
I go forth.
I have to keep an eye on Marienburg. I'm sure they'll be marching on us at any point here. Our public order is still having issues with it, though. I wonder if we're still having problems with the orcs. Yeah, they're still attacking our province. I really don't know how to get rid of that. I guess we just have to wait for 14 turns. Well, that's a pretty brutal thing to have happen to you in the first turn. Alright, let's pass the turn and let's see what happens. I feel like Marienburg's going to be knocking on our door pretty soon, though. I'd stake my knight's honor upon it.
You seek the lady's favor.
Monsieur Leonco?
My journey begins.
Okay, let's help to stem the tide, at least, of this rising problem with our public order. What can we do? How much more until you are large enough? or until you have enough growth that I can upgrade you. Hopefully soon. Okay, we're going to pass a few turns here. It doesn't really look like too much is going to be happening for a little while, and I will see you guys in just a moment. Oh dear, so it would appear that the treacherous merchants, the dogs of the Empire, have attacked our nice little beautiful settlement here on the coast called Languille. So we are going to kick they asses. I think we have the forces here necessary to beat them. It's just, you know, a small amount of infantry and some of those pistoliers, who honestly aren't any match for our peasant bowmen, who are pretty cost-effective. They're good for what they are. Let's fight this, and I'll see you guys on the battlefield. Okay, here we are. We're going to be hiding our infantry and such in the forest here. I really don't want to leave them out in the open so that their crossbows. Seen. They're in there somewhere. Yeah, you can see some of the crossbows right here. I don't want to leave them out in the open so they can do work on our troops. We have quite low morale. Very, very easy to break us, whereas the Empire soldiers are not a whole lot better than our basic troops, but they do have much higher morale, so this is going to come down to who can break whom first. So what we're going to be doing is hiding some of our mounted yeomen over here in this little wooded copse, and hopefully we'll be able to catch one of these units of pistoliers with their pants down, which I think will really sort of shift things in our favor. So let's see how it goes. Hopefully we can win this fight for Bretonnia and for the lady. It would appear. Yeah, we don't really want them to go directly through that forested area. So let's move our troops now out here. They can kind of see where we are, and it looks like we might have that opportunity that I spoke of earlier. Hopefully we can catch some of these damned pistoliers. They are a pain in the ass. I don't know if you guys have ever really run into them in your campaigns, but holy crap, are they annoying! So, wiping out one of them very, very quickly, and it looks like we're going to have that opportunity. Oh, yeah. Oh, I can taste it. Slaughter them! Oh, no, we're going to lose that opportunity. Damn it, they saw us. Okay, so let's get the hell out of there. Our mounted yeomen are going to break very, very quickly. Oh, no, they're going in for a surround. So let's quickly into fire at these guys, and we'll draw them out with our mounted yeomen, and they're gonna get some pain dealt to them by our archers, who are now in range. Come on, boys! Yeah, slaughter those bastards! Damn it! This is really a waste of my yeomen, but I can't get away from those frickin' pistoliers because they're so fast. They're like the most obnoxious early game unit I've ever seen. What we got here? We have an opportunity, I think. Surround this unit of swordsmen. Yeah, let's bring our cavalry in and around. If we can break this unit, we'll be able to swarm this one very, very quickly. But we are going to run out of time. Yeah, you can see our peasants here, our spearmen at arms, really having a hard time against even Empire spearmen. Come on, quickly! Quickly. Let's see, one of those units of pistoliers now beginning to break. That is good news. Come on, peasants, just hold on just a little bit longer. Let's hit these swordsmen. There we are. One more hammer and anvil might be enough to break them. Charge! Let's hit those crossbowmen now. Let's try and give these guys a little bit of a break. And we hit those peasant, or hit those spearmen. Now let's go in for these crossbows. Oh, hold on. These guys are about on the verge of breaking. Let's hit them. Let's hit them hard. Oh, maybe we can get some routing going on. That would be prime. Yep, back we go. Oh, those pistoliers are back. Oh, man. Our infantry is just so terrible. Oh, man, let's try and break this corner. I'm pretty sure this is a lost cause over there. We're starting to lose our yeomen now. Got some more pistoliers over here. Let's try and get rid of them. Oh no. Oh no, they're routing! This is the worst. That is... What? What just happened? This really sucks. hopefully our yeomen come back, because they're really all that's keeping us in this fight. Oh man. That really sucks. We totally outplayed those Empire dogs. There's no reason they should have won this. Unfortunately, that is a valiant defeat. So we'll have to move out with Luan Leoncoeur and his army and take the settlement back. I'll see you guys back on... Oh, hold on. Yes, getting a little bit ahead of myself. I know. There you are. Your casualty screen. I'll see you guys back on the campaign. Mm-hmm. A valiant defeat. Hopefully we can reach Anguille easily from Couronne. Ambush failed. At the same time, they're bringing up another unit from... or another very heavy army from Marienburg. Yeah, that's a problem. Okay, so we're not going to have the opportunity, I think, to take this back from them. Hmm. This is very unfortunate. Why are we taking attrition? Imminent incursion. Oh, crap. Some orcs now about to pop up out of nowhere. Well, I think we're going to have to just deal with the loss of Anguille for the moment. Really don't know what else we can do. Let's see. Irrigation. -5 upkeep. That might help. More income from farms. Let's go for some more of that. It's going to take 10 turns. We'll see if we actually manage to survive for 10 turns. Look at that great army from Marienburg there. I think we're about to have another goblin incursion into our lands as well. Definitely not easy. We just got to get out of this defensive alliance, you say? Oh, Leoness, thank you. Thank you, my friends. Come and help me, please. Emile the Astute. What we got up there? Otto Boca. Well, that'd be the small army. We really want them to attack us, though. Because if we do that, we'll get a very nice garrison from Couronne, which is going to help us push them back. Yeah, look at that. Some more knights, some mounted yeomen, another trebuchet. A lot of good stuff. A lot of infantry, which we are definitely lacking in at the moment. Well, let's see if we can induce our ally here, Leoness, to come and save us. Maybe.
The laws of chivalry demand, I hear.
I definitely need you to help me. What's the point of a defensive alliance if you're not going to help me against people that attack me? Come on! Join war against Marienburg. You might do it. Really? Some ally you are. Alright, well, all I can see to do at this point is to pass the turn. Hopefully they are stupid enough to attack us in Couronne. Which, oh great. Now we're going to have another goblin army out there. Well, we are being raided. Children of the Lady, what does this do? Whilst absently observing the noble children playing in the castle grounds, the squire observes them displaying a certain magical affinity. Could their latent talents be harnessed? It doesn't really matter because I can't do either of those things.
The lady and my right.
Okay, we're just gonna... Yeah, we need to preserve our numbers as best as we can. We're gonna destroy those damned goblins.
Farewell. Warrior King. Hold true.
Yeah, let's go and attack them. And finish them off. There we go. So now we don't have to worry about them raiding our lands or coming back with an even larger army. That's one threat. Handily dealt with. Let us pop over here. Looks like these guys are trying to encamp.
Ride,
so let's hit them as well.
To glory. My journey begins. For glory.
Alright, got another couple levels here. Let's expend our points on something useful. That will be nice. +3 melee for peasants. That's kind of good as well. This is what we need right now. Our economy is going to collapse on us. You, what can you do for us? Roiling skies. Wind blast. Definitely very useful. Alright, and now let's hope that Emile the Astute and his army of Marienburgers are stupid enough to attack Couronne because if we can deal with this threat here now behind our lines, we'll be able to circle back around. We'll have a couple units, I think, of replenishment turns, and then we'll be able to come to the aid of our brothers inside of Kulan. So hopefully they do that. If not, they might come and just attack us, and then we'll be kind of stuck out here and unable to defend ourselves, which could be very bad. Well, let's see what happens. Marion Bird's going to try and get away. Oh, they're going to sail away. That's really annoying. I forgot that you could just pull flotillas out of your ass, apparently, in Total War Warhammer. Great. So now we get plus 10 chivalry, which is cool. Chaos Corruption. We'll increase our treasury. We don't really have anything to spend money on at the moment. Yeah. But at the moment... Yeah, we're kind of desperate. Okay, fine.
By the light of the lady.
No, I won't be able to do that.
On for the lady.
But that did push them back. So now let's move a little bit farther forward. Maybe we'll be able to take Anguille, get our economy back on track. Let's see what happens. Crap. Well, could be worse, I suppose.
The lady's chosen.
Close enough to be able to get them. They might just run away. On the other hand, our economy. Oh, this is a hard one. We're going to take back Guy. Do that very quickly. There we are. Occupy. Yeah, definitely not going to sack. We're not going to raise it because that will decrease our chivalry by a huge amount. Great. Now we have another city,
King Lewin,
which is good.
Who calls?
Won't be able to move anymore this turn, unfortunately. But let's see what we can do for ourselves. The Lady's Champion. That is really cool. We're definitely going to do that. And then the next thing I think we'll get will be the leadership for our army. You know what? Let's do that now. We are definitely low on leadership. All right, let's pass the turn and see what happens. Those damned Marienburgers, I see them. Okay, now they're kind of sailing away. We got an agent coming in to be a pain in the butt now.
You ask for
a trade agreement, that'll be nice. Help our economy get back on its feet again. We're still hemorrhaging money, I'm not sure how. Alright. So we're gonna have to take these guys on in the field. Alright, still doable. I will see you guys on the battlefield. Alright, same map, same enemy, same plan. We're going to draw the greenskins in if they're going to do what I think they're going to do, and they probably will because they're orcs and kind of dumb. They'll probably overcommit into the center, taking on the enemy that they can see, rather than worrying too much about what might be hiding and lying in wait for them in the forest. So I hope that's what happens. We'll see. I really need this army to not get destroyed. There we go. We'll take our warriors down onto this hill. Move them in front of our missile troops. And as usual, we have some nasty surprises down here waiting in the woods for the orcs. Hopefully this will be the last battle we have to fight against them, and this will convince them to leave fair Bretonnia once and for good. We'll see if that happens. For now, we have to be patient. Got our warriors now getting into position. Look at that. Taking down some of those spider riders, which is good. Important. What do we got over here? I'm going to move in with my Pegasus Knights and take out that rock lava. Let's move Luan Leoncoeur and his warriors into combat now. Let's take down these damn spider riders. Quickly, quickly, quickly. They're probably a little bit farther back than I would have liked them to be. Oh, crap. This could be bad. Looks like they're gonna take that challenge. Thank you for doing that. That was really stupid. Yeah, bring some spearmen now into the back of them. Destroy them quickly before the rest of the orcs can get up the hill. Direct our bowmen fire onto these advancing soldiers. Uh-oh. Time to bring out our Grail Knights. Now was the time! Some Night Goblins here engaging our front line. How are we doing over here? Break these guys? Yes, we have. Bring these spearmen now into the flank of these. Actually, you know what? No, no, no. Get behind them. Let's use her a little bit more. Oh crap, they've broken our... This is very bad. They have broken our left flank because I was a little bit sluggish in getting my my warriors into where they needed to be. Some Grail Knights I think will be enough to do that, to deal with them. Let's focus with our trebuchets on their archers down there. Yeah, let's flank these guys. Bring yourselves around. Attack! What's Leoncoeur doing right here? It's like some goblos. Some goblos here have gotten themselves in combat with our lord. Should be enough to break them. Look at that. See them all fleeing for their lives now. Okay, so these archers have now been broken. Bring our cavalry around. And stop you two from firing now. You guys as well. Unless you're shooting those. There we are. Forward, brothers! Drive them from our lands! Look at this glorious charge. You guys can stop what you're doing. The rest of you, charge! For fair, Bretonnia! We've driven them off the hill. Looks like this battle is pretty much ours. Run down these arrow boys. And they're surprisingly fast for orcs. Not gonna be enough to get away from my cavalry, though. Oh, look at them die. Get destroyed. What are we doing over here? Pretty good by the looks of it. Man, those arrow boys falling like leaves in autumn, to use a corny metaphor. Hey, we're knights. We like puppetry. And turns of phrase. Alright, I kind of forgot about these guys back here. They would have been useful in running down some of these warriors, but oh well. My attention was elsewhere. That is it. We win. They are destroyed. They are routed. See what we did. Our melee infantry doing surprisingly well. Look at that, 54 and 68. Our cavalry, of course, slaughtering everything, as they do. As they do. Looks like their general is down as well. A little bit more costly than I would have liked, though. Well, let's finish these guys off once and for good. Get out of my country. There we are. Hopefully we don't get attacked now by those bloody Marienburgers. Let's quickly apply their skill ups. That'll be nice. Let's do that. The Lady's Champion, that's kind of cool. Basic training. Anything that gives us more leadership? It would appear not. Okay, so the Lady's Champion it is. Alright, it's best turn. The Marienburgers are retreating. That's good. I guess they fear our prowess in the field. That's really good news for us. So now we've got our territory back. The Marienburgers have been driven back as well. And the orcs have been slaughtered in numbers untold. Yeah, that's right. Get out of here.
Glory awaits.
All right, so I think that's going to do for the episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the first episode of our Bretonnia campaign. I hope you will join me again for episode 2. As for what's going to be coming up next, we'll probably do some of our other regular series as well. We've done a lot of replays in the last little while. So we'll have one more of our regular series, probably Lorien. And or maybe even some more 4th Age. You know, I've been really digging 4th Age lately. And then we'll follow that up with another battle replay. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you then. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye!